All right. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. That's like all you did for a week. You just like you built pipes and fences, and you didn't eat, you didn't do anything, you didn't like drink, you didn't sleep. You just built fences and pipes all week.
I drank sprinkler water coming from the pipes. Of course, one time a mouse came out of one of the pipes. So I don't think that's too good for me.
Dot dot dot. Okay, yeah. Well, what about you guys?
Yeah, Melina, Kahi.
Well, one day I didn't appear on Skype at all because I was doing about 11 and a half hours worth of math homework because I fell a little bit behind. And apparently some of the assignments that I had done, I thought I had completed. And when I looked back, I realized in dismay that they weren't done like I had thought they were. So, and I had a test the next day on math, and I wanted as much extra credit as I could get.
I remember that when you were gone, and we were like, "Oh no, where's Alina?"
Yeah.
And, then we didn't talk about it for hours.
Don't worry, Alina. We kept a spot open in the call for you, and a knife ready to be stabbed back into my head.
I can pull up that picture if you want. Yeah, I replicated that in Minecraft. Just a knife going straight in.
Go to Karzani, LJ.
fine. Wait, no, I can't. Galley Nuva took out Karzani a while back.
Dude, I'm gonna like put up that picture I made in Minecraft. It's like the slideshow picture in this part of the episode. Just like of you getting stabbed in the knife.
I made a picture of me getting stabbed in the face for like a thingamabob.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Then I took it to the extreme and made it in Minecraft.
Yeah. Yep.
It's all just being magnified on a scale. Is very lowly.
Yeah. Yep. I'm always best when I'm bigger than everyone else and squishing on tiny little glitching out flowers.
Okay. But LJ, I'm taller than you. You can't be bigger than everyone else.
Stop it! Stop it!
In fact, I'm one of the tallest people in TTV, except for, I think, Ben and Teddy.
I'm not listening! Anyway, let's test their names.
Oh, how's life? Kahi never gave a response.
Yes, I've been patiently waiting for everybody to complete, because everybody
okay,
said I talked too much.
So...
Alright, leaks went on as usual. Got a calculus test is basically all I'm focusing on. I want to get that Halo 4, yo.
Yeah. That is very true. Yeah. Because in calculus, doing fun tests gets you games.
I know, right? My dad said if I got like a B in the overall grade in Calculus 1, he'd think about pre-ordering Halo 4 for me. So,
well,
there we go.
Our fans are cheering for you.
I know, right? I'm sure everybody's very happy for me.
You have like a bunch of people just clapping and screaming in like, Kahi, 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 you can do it. Actually, you probably don't, but whatever.
Cat lovers aren't screaming your name. And well, they are screaming their name, but
they are screaming
have to
my name.
Say, no! Don't eat Fluffy!
That's exactly how I like my cats. Light and Fluffy.
Yeah, so before I get sued for that one, here's what we have.
Yeah, okay. Moving on, we're not going to offend anyone here.
It's late. I spoke.
Yeah.
You know what, Kahi? I am tired of you constantly talking about eating cats, so you know what?
So am I.
You know what I'm gonna do, Kai?
Is it gonna cost me money?
I'm going to hire a lawyer and sue you.
Wow.
And you know who this lawyer's gonna be? Kai.
You're gonna have Kai sue himself?
Yes.
I'll do it. Think about it this way. I'll defend myself, and I'll attack myself. I know who's going to win, and I know whose money is going to pay me. Who knows? It's a win-win situation, the win being me.
You know, that's the best circular logic I think I've heard in quite a long time.
Yeah, well, how's about we go with some straight-line logic and remind people about who we are?
Yep, I can do that.
Pathetic. Yes, right on logic. Yes.
What are you saying, LJ?
Come on. Alright.
So, yeah, I'm Mesonak.
I'm LJ.
I'm Elena.
And I'm Kahi.
This is TTV episode 31, because I actually didn't need to get LJ to remind me to say the episode number this week, because I forgot.
Oh, cool.
Anyway.
Reminded you via mental link.
No, you reminded me via, I think we're forgetting something. What's the number of the episode?
Yeah, that too. That too.
What?
Oh, nothing. I just said the episode name. Well, not name number. There is no episode name. Yet. Anyway. Well, let's transition into our first segment of the episode, because I don't like wasting time. The news. In the news this week, we have release date announced for Lego Movie. The Monster Fighters are alive. Superhero Movie Maker app hits iTunes Store. Legoland Malaysia coming to Asia. Extended Conflict. The 2012 BZB T-shirt project. Finished Prada collection. And VMK for auction. And answer some questions for Lego. And that's the news and commentary.
Hip, hip, hooray. Bionic news.
Yep.
I know, right?
Bionic
well,
news.
Well, Lego and Malaysia. Yay, I guess. It would have been better had, you know, they'd done that a couple years ago.
Yeah, you were actually in Malaysia at one point, weren't
yes,
you?
Last summer during the downtime.
Yeah.
I never heard of it.
I remember you kept on bragging that you were eating mangosteen. And here I sat. Here I sat thinking...
Oh, I remember that. Oh, it was hilarious watching
I'll tell you
stuff.
This, right? There's one thing about Malaysia is that there's food everywhere. I mean, like, in Asian countries specifically, but like, you know, Malaysia and Singapore, there's food everywhere. We have people going down, you have carts, you have, you know, you can just stop by something, order something to go. Like, imagine if you had the ice cream man, right? But he didn't just bring ice cream. He brings everything. Like, literally, he brings everything. You just stop by and it's like dirt cheap. Like you got a mangosteen for about 50 cents. And just a giant bag of mangosteens, fresh mangosteen, not the frozen kinds that LJ is probably leaving in here. Fresh mangosteen. And just you take them and like for those who don't know, I mean you've probably seen a mangosteen before because LJ like spammed it all over the place.
Hey.
But it's a purple fruit, right? But the outside is kind of I don't know how to say it. It's hard, but not too hard. You can, It's like the inside of an orange. Not the actual orange itself, but the inside of an orange peel. It's sort of like that. So you have to press it. Yeah, press it on both ends and sort of like rip it apart and hope the juices come on you. Because like the juice will never get off. Mangosteen juice does not come. I think that's the reason they don't allow it in America.
The reason they don't allow it in America is because of bugs and import laws and
stuff
like that. Yeah, Kahi. Yeah, if you were a dedicated mangosteen lover like I am, you would know that.
You're just a fool.
Yeah. It's I guess the orange is the best thing to it. It's like an orange. It has seeds and stuff in it, but it's not like an orange. It's more gooey. No, not gooey. You know what I mean, right? LJ, come on. What's the taste like? What does the texture feel?
Mangosteen kind of tastes like... Okay, wait. Why are we even talking about mangosteen right now?
Because you know, it's just Malaysia. All right. So, yeah, basically, yeah, I was on webcam. No, I wasn't on webcam. Everybody else is on webcam. I nearly got on just to eat a mangosteen in front of LJ. Like, I, up to that point, not to my face, I'm like, no, this is almost too worth it. Anyhow, Malaysia, I'm not sure where they're going to put it. That's my thing. Where are you going to put it? Did it say they like the new support?
On the water.
Yeah.
Water. Like, seriously?
I don't know. I don't even know. You should, like, do a TTV coverage of Legoland Malaysia. Just go back and just, like, eat a bunch of mangosteens. You just, like, walk around, showcase the park, and then just, like, eat a bunch of mangosteens on camera.
Yeah, eat a bunch of mangosteens. And just say, stuff.
So, shout out to LJ, my good friend. Yeah. you're here in spirit.
Yeah.
Your spirit is on.
No, you're here in spirit, and here you are in this little mangosteen. I can hear you screaming right now.
Yep. But
anyway. Yeah, why is the press release in what looks to be like a blog?
Dude, I'm not even sure.
Because people, I guess.
People are strange. That's all I have to say. People are really strange. That's a phrase which applies to a lot of scenarios. One of which, coming up right next, how about that there Lego movie?
If it was... It was CGI, I would say. It might be believable. It might actually work. When you throw live action in the mist and you have the whole master builder thing, I don't know. It's just, it seems too cheesy to be live action. Yeah. Like, if they were just doing it like, you know, animated Lego movie, right? You just have Legos, you're doing this animated movie with them, and then this whole master builder thing, I'd be like, okay, you know, that actually, you know, that's a good concept it's worth working with. When you try to do that in real life, there's some... It's like the suspension of disbelief. I don't know if that'll sell. Like,
well, I'm gonna be nice to our fans, and I'm gonna actually read the plot synopsis if you do not mind.
Right.
I'm right. Like, so basically, it is the story of a young man who doesn't have a creative bone in his body, and he has to always build things from the instructions. He's an instructions worker in the Lego City. They build buildings. And it turns out in this universe, it's illegal to build apart from the instructions. So what he finds out is that he's actually a descendant from these, like, super creative Jedi-type people who are called Master Builders. And he has been charged with saving the universe from being frozen together by an evil bad guy. So over the course of the movie, he has to unlearn all that lame-o, uncreative stuff and learn how to build without all the instructions in order to save the universe.
That is the most forceful way to make someone creative I've ever heard of. It's like, hey, little boy, you see this universe? It's so restrictive that you cannot build the only way you know how. We are going to literally drill it into your brain that the instructions are horribly evil things. Just always build from anything else, even if it looks about as bad as any one of LJ's MLCs.
I mean, that's the biggest thing, right? This is the Lego, like, official Lego movie, and they're saying, you know those stuff that we always include in the box? You know, that stuff that we, like, you know, that we actually sell to you? The models? Yeah, you're not supposed to actually build them. Actually, it's evil that you think about building them. Like, somewhere, everybody builds it, and it's just, it's terrible, and because of this, some bad guys destroy the world. Because you fall right in the box, some dude is going to destroy the world. You pitiful little person. I can't believe you do this, your universe.
Dude!
What the heck are we talking about?
The Lego movie.
Yeah.
You should listen more to what we're actually saying.
This is the movie that's coming out on February 28th, 2014. I know this is obligatory, but TTV coverage.
No!
So, did we do CTV coverage clutch powers? We should have done CTV clutch powers.
The reason I see CTV coverage so much is because, for those that don't know, because no one will know probably from our YouTube fans, we do occasionally CTV coverage of LEGO-related movies, where it's basically us watching the movie live with live commentary, and the whole gimmick is you're supposed to watch it with us, and we synchronize our viewing times, and you actually watch the movie and then listen to us as we talk and give it up our opinions on it. It's pretty funny, because some of the absurd stuff that happened in, like, The Legend Reborn or Web of Shadows, it was just hilarious to listen to us talking about it. And the reason I always say, oh, TTV coverage this, TTV coverage that, is because we haven't done one in, like, 2 years. And yeah. We did one for Legends of Metronui, and it was never released.
I want to redo all of the TTV coverages, because I love the Bionicle movies so much. And, those are the best. But anything, if it's not a Bionicle movie, and it's not a Hero Factory TV show, no.
Well, there's plenty of opportunities, Aldo. There's Ninja Go, there's Clutch Powers, there's the Lego movie.
You know what? Your coveraging of everything has inspired Alina to want to do a TTV coverage on her cats. Do you want to subject us to them?
Isn't there a movie called Cats?
There's... Oh my god. Okay, Soda?
No, we're not doing this.
Anyhow, alright. Basically, all you need to know is TTV coverage. It's like a director commentary, but without the directors and with teenage guys that just meet over the internet.
Alina's not a guy. Oh, wait, no.
I just we do know. Never mind.
I just realized that the coverages only have me, Meso, and Lauren.
Mm-hmm. And at one point,
me, no, they don't.
Yeah, and Keeney at one point. And then he left for 6 months.
But like, yeah, the Lego movie coming out February 28th, 2014 by the Animal Logic, the animation, the esteemed Animal Logic. Yeah.
The esteemed Animal Logic.
I'm very excited.
It would be much more esteemed if I ever heard of him.
I know, right?
Like you say, esteemed Warner Media. Okay, yeah. You sold me. I'm done. True. Like, Animal Logic. Wow.
Well, moving on to things that are quite odd. How about the Monster Fighters?
Yeah.
I beg you. Watch the story synopsis. It's very enlightening. And it really shows. It's on their website, I believe.
What was the bad guy's name again, Mesa?
Lord Vampire.
Okay. No.
At least he's a natural vampire.
Ah!
That's Sparkle. He's an actual vampire. Kids should fear vampires. All right. If you ever have a vampire that kids don't fear, you're doing it wrong. At least Lego is doing its part to bring back the evil vampires.
That is actually true. This whole theme, it seems like they're actually putting in a good bit of effort into it. Not just for the sets, but, you know, Lego's main story franchise was Bionicle. And anything other than Bionicle really can't live up to Bionicle's standards. But Ninjago's done pretty good. Hero Factory, it's a matter of opinion whether it does good or not. And then Monster Fighters, Atlantis, all those themes try really, really hard to appeal to kids, and maybe teenagers too. Monster Fighters more so than Atlantis. Monster Fighters is actively trying to be interesting. And it is actually kind of interesting. I wonder if they're going to do a TV special like Ninjago on Cartoon Network.
Maybe. Yeah.
Well, when you watch the trailer, it really does set itself up for that kind of thing.
For me, it's like hold it. Let me pause it. My bad. Go on, Ellie.
Anything Lego related that's animated that isn't Ninjago or Hero Factory or Clutch Powers, apparently, fear it. Fear it with your ever living, loving soul.
Monica, just putting that out there. Out of the things you might not want to fear, out of all the Lego movies that they've done, to be fair, like the Monica movies did have their share of cheesiness, but In the very least, there's a lot of times in the story itself where it really seemed to appeal to older viewers.
Yeah.
When it comes to, like, Ninjago and Hero Factory, I think they're doing, I guess in my opinion, they're doing a good job. But, like, I always see it as, like, you know, it's good for a kid's show.
Yeah.
I guess it was a bit with the Bionicle movies, but with the story itself, I never really thought that, you know, like, oh, it's doing good for a kid's show. Bionicle was just doing good. It was just a story, you know?
Yep.
Like sort of like Avatar or whatever.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, speaking of Bionicle, very quickly, I think I should mention this. Last time we did a TTV episode, we mentioned the Faber files.
Mm-hmm.
Did we mention the Matanui fauna concepts?
Nope.
Okay, good. Well, ever since we finished that mentioning of Faber files, since then there have Matanui fauna concepts, Bionicle sunglass concepts, the Hatching Borg picture we all know and love, the Karnui concept we all know and love, Bionicle planet system concept, basically meaning the shattering and the solar system-esque thing between the three planets, and then the Mask of Life concept art.
Dude, so I didn't even know this was up.
Go check those out, and I'm pretty sure next week we'll also mention some more stuff that's up, because there's more than likely.
Why didn't you tell me?
I told you right now.
Well, time to go look and give my opinions live.
I'll save you the trouble. There you go.
Wow, at all these concepts.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. So, yeah. But yeah, for this LEGO movie...
We're done talking about the LEGO movie.
I forgot.
Monster Fighters.
All right. For this Monster Fighters thing...
Apparently the people that made Breakout in the game are going to be making a game for Monster Fighters.
That's it. I'm not touching this with a 10-foot pole. We're going to know that there's going to be one level in that game with a wall. That will be the end of this game!
Dude, it's so funny. I couldn't get past that for months. I just recently was finally able to, and I actually played it, and it was mildly entertaining. I'm a completionist. I've got every secret and every collectible in Breakout. Now I'm going to get every achievement one day. Years from now.
Achievement hunter. You're back to Breakout.
Alina, what do you think of the Monster Hunters? Whatever.
Ghostbusters. Ghost Train Busters.
Give me a second. I haven't really heard too much about it.
Yeah, no one has.
Yeah, you're not alone. Very vague.
I'm done.
Very odd thing.
I guess Ellie, your theme song right now is All By You. No, I'm not doing that either.
Good. So no. Stop living your life.
So the part looks so weird. And
yep, I agree.
I went to the website and the lead guy, I don't know why, but for some reason he reminds me of Indiana Jones, the Lego minifigure.
Done.
I don't know why. Okay, let me see. Could it be that he's the Chubb Explorer going around the world looking for ancient artifacts to revive ancient humans? Because that's sort of why I was reminded of Indiana Jones. But
no, it was appearance-wise. I don't know why, but for some reason he just reminds me of Indiana Jones whenever I look at him.
It's the monocle.
Yep. Hilarity.
Oh, and that chick minifigure in the back with the arrow being used for something. Yeah, that's kind of stupid. Take it off.
The arrow in her head? Yeah, no, I think it's actually kind of fitting. I mean, think about it. It's gonna show how she dies in the TV show.
Hello.
I hope she dies.
Some little child out there is gonna listen to what you just said after going there and saying, "That's my favorite character. She's so cool." Then hear what you said and go like,
"Wow."
No!
And then they're going to hear what you said and start laughing at how funny and stupid-sounded you are.
It's funny because it's true. Anyway.
Let's just continue on.
Y'all, is there anything else you guys want to talk about before we break from this?
No.
Anything else interesting?
The UDD symbol. I found that interesting about in the Monocle system. Vapor files.
Yeah, it really is.
Going back to that, sorry. But yeah, it's how it merged together. It was supposed to, like, become this one thing.
Mm-hmm.
I guess seeing it visually helps me to envision the actual, like, how everything fit together more.
Yeah. It is actually fairly amazing.
Yeah.
It's really cool. I'm glad he's putting these up.
Mm-hmm. Like, see, it says right here, it says Spherus Magna, 2009-2011 location, and then Jungle Moon, 2011 location.
It's funny, because that's actually where it was supposed to take place.
Yep.
And technically, it did take place there, because the story was continued a little bit further in 08, before its inevitable... After Greg left. But the funny thing is, this concept art was made in 2008.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. How sad.
Yep.
Anyway, how about life, guys? No, I'm kidding.
So, that's about all the news we're talking about, right?
I think so.
Yeah, me too.
That ends the news segment. It was fairly interesting. More so than I had thought it'd be. So, hooray.
Yep.
Anyway. Moving on to another very interesting thing. Can't wait to get into. Meso, you're up. No, I'm kidding.
Oh, my God. That is the most pitiful thing I've heard.
No, that's the second most pitiful thing I've heard. The first would be great, comment, subscribe.
Wow. Well, all right. Here we go. I'm Mesonak, and without further ado, no more wasting time, let's take a look at what's going to be brought to attention today. Hooray! Well, I want to highlight a topic on the BZ Power forums. So let me go to the BZ Power forums to find this topic. What? The voids are offline? What? What is this? What is this? What is this? What happened, guys?
Gee, I have no idea. Why don't you tell us all that, though? We should all this experience.
Alright, fine. Basically, long story short, BZP got hacked. No surprise. This was always years and years and years have passed. It still gets hacked. And the forums are down. This has never happened before, so I'm just kind of shocked and appalled that this would happen.
Mind if I give a little bit of a more in-depth story, or would you like to do that?
Well, I don't know what happened, okay. So you go ahead.
It's actually ironic.
I'm going to go ahead, because this is my segment.
Gosh darn it.
Good sir. Silence.
Fine.
Yep. Yesterday, well, actually, I wasn't there for it, because I was asleep. But apparently, so actually, I'm going to go back on what I said. You tell them what happened, because I was asleep.
Yeah, I was actually there when it happened. So, in about 3 o'clock in the morning, mountain time, BZ Power, I had been alerted that BZ Power had been hacked. Going to the front page, here I find that there had been multiple messages put up on the front page saying, we will rise, like, the end is near, open your eyes and the whole thing like that. Basically, BZPower had been hacked by an unknown, apparently unknown hacker that we later found out to be known as Crackjag. The messages were then taken down, and subsequently the forms, a few minutes after they were posted up. I then went to sleep. Waking up the next morning, here we find that BZPower had a new message on its front page. The typical, all your base belong to us. That
all your database.
That generic stuff. Crackjag had then taken, he managed to take over the BZPower front page. Basically, the literal database. He then said, leave the message up or else. BZPower takes the message down. He takes down all the staff bios, subsequently afterwards. So, then, he says, okay, we've come to an agreement. Now bring the forms back online. Or else. The whole goal of the hacking was to, well, liberate BZPower, as he kept on saying. He updated, he gave various contact information, etc., etc. Later on, he then gave a timer to the BZPower staff of about around 15 minutes. When the 15-minute timer was up, he deleted, within about 5 minutes, 12 years worth of Bionicle news.
Yep.
Do you want me to tell him how it ended, Meso?
Yeah, but...
Basically, the BZPower staff called in a good old friend of theirs, Kelly McKernan, the former head of the Bionicle website and BionicleStory.com, to fix up the problem. They found how Crackjag had got in, shut him out, and repaired the forms, bringing back all of what had been lost. The forms are currently down due to security patches and other maintenance. And the hacker was effectively shut out and gave up.
We thought.
Yep. apparently, later on today, the day of this recording, he opened up the private staff forms for public viewing.
So if there was ever any doubt that there were any private staff forums, that doubt has been completely erased. They exist.
Yeah.
Not that any of us were that dumb to not realize they existed.
Exactly. So, that...
But didn't you, Mickey, say that there were no staff forums? No.
So that's basically the gist of it. Yeah, BZPower's apparently... What now? You lagged up?
I don't know what's going on. I don't know if he's still in the system or if he's been driven out or if he's out of the main database but he's still lingering around in the offline forums or if he just gave up entirely and just said, forget this, I'm going to come back and do one more thing and then give up. I don't know what's going on with the whole scenario.
Well, apparently... We need a bit of correction there. It was the entire forums that are open up alongside the staff forums. So basically the entire board was taken from offline to back online. Apparently band members and members that are logged out can both view all forums and they can also post, apparently. I'm not sure how that would work exactly, but
well, yeah. Easily. Because the band members section was absolutely 100% removed.
Yep.
Effectively rendering all band members unbanned.
It's the breakout. IRL.
Hi, Matt Tanui. All right, Miss. Wait, you ready, Miss O? We got a job to do.
It's breakout zone power.
Oh, my Matt Tanui.
Good. Shut up. Shut up now.
Okay, now we gotta go trap the... Because there's so many breakouts, we're gonna send one hero, one premier member, after every... after multiple band members. I'm gonna be sent out. Sound blast! Bam.
Meanwhile, Crackjag, believed to be the mastermind behind the breakout, infiltrates the factory in order to forward... forum... cough, to transfer several critical files to the real mastermind, the Men in Black.
And not the cool kind, like Will Smith and the lot.
Yep.
The infamous hackers.
Yep. But anyway. Yeah, that's basically what happened. I'm not sure where the whole situation stands, but I guess we'll know pretty soon. Because, you know, it's an ongoing thing. If they get put back up, all's resolved. If they don't get put back up, nothing's resolved.
Guess which forum has to update some security patches in the meantime?
Yep.
Update their forums.
Update the forums. So, we'll see you guys in 6 months. No new episodes because we can't post them on BCP. Wait a sec. We're all good. We're prepared for downtimes like this because we have YouTube as a means of getting stuff out because we're very fortunate people and we thought ahead. Our fears have been justified. Nothing bad will happen. Everything's well. The end. But yeah, who knows when it'll be back.
Yeah, Alina prophesizes it'll be another 7 months downtime, and honestly, I cannot help but agree with her.
As long as he's still somewhat in the database, yeah, it could be like another couple months. Just depends on how long he lingers around.
Yeah. Anyhow.
Yeah, Alina, you were kind of there for the last little bit of this. What are your opinions on that?
The hacking incident?
Mm-hmm.
I think we all should have seen it coming, like, the staff don't make the best of decisions, and I think everyone here is just found it absolutely stupid that it took them 7 months to bring up the forums.
Yeah, I have to agree.
And...
Go on.
Personally, I think that the hacker might be overreacting a bit, but, I mean, it's pretty much just a forum, and, sorry, you guys took me by surprise. It's just a forum, and it's not really like anything this people on the forum do will affect your real life, and I can understand why you'd be pissed. I mean, just leave out what I was gonna say. I have no clue what I was saying.
I get what you're saying. I definitely think this guy kind of is in a little bit over his head because. It's just a Bionicle fan site, and while I can see his reasonings very well, no one had any problems. The forum was just getting back on its feet. Everything was fine. I mean, I honestly can't see why he'd do this now, of all times. Fun fact, this happened a few days after the one-year anniversary of the beginning of the BZ Power downtime of last year.
Fun facts. The more you know.
So, yeah. It doesn't make sense.
For those people that state that BZ Power is a dictatorship, simply because of this, BZ Power is not a government. And because of this, you can't say something is a dictatorship because they're not a government. They're privately owned. BZ Power is a privately owned site. I mean, they can do whatever they want, legally speaking. And, you know, nothing will affect them. So saying it's a dictatorship is just incorrect. It's not a government. It can't be labeled as such. You might say it's unfair, or you might say that they have unfair practices, which is true sometimes, depending on your point of view. But, there's so many things that no one really knows about. But, sometimes you can't say something is a dictatorship when it's not a government. It's a dictatorship is reserved for, like, a type of government that is run a certain way. And this isn't a type of government.
No, it's just like a Lego forum.
Yeah. Yeah. So,
when in reality, you should really pick your battles. It's like,
So, yeah, I guess, you know, that's the little government lesson for today. Anyone who says music power is a dictatorship now is incorrect. Might be, you know, doesn't mean like they're totally right in everything they do, but they're not a dictatorship. They can't be.
Yeah.
Until they
become a nation. And that annoys me when people use that phrase incorrectly to just like, it's like, oh, they banned this person without telling everyone the reason why. They're a dictatorship. It's like they throw words around. I've seen people throw words around for the stupidest of things, the most trivial of things. Like a friend getting banned, or a word filter, or an advertising policy. You know?
Compare it to like a secret police, some people say, or a conspiracy theorist label it as, you know, something going on. Not really. It's a private business, so technically they can withhold information and or fire people as they please.
Yeah, that's true. Well, yeah, that's basically... That was brought to attention where Meso barely spoke.
Yep.
Tune in next week for more Hero Factory versus Biotical rants. So, yeah, that was brought to attention.
Next would be a Biotical rant, right? But anyhow,
that is true.
Yeah.
But that was brought to attention. Now we're going to actually continue this line of thought and discussion in a more fitting segment. The premier, if you will use that wording, the premier event for this segment. Kahi, you're up.
Right. Okay, so this is the first time we ever had this segment, so proceed it with some general information. This segment is what we like to call the debate corner. Basically, when two people in TTD have different viewpoints on a certain subject, we just bring it here. We record it and we let you guys hear about it. Why? Because we can, and because we have another segment this week. Ta-da! Okay, so where I like to start is that. Me and LJ, because, LJ is going to be, I'm not sure, there's no really defensive prosecution this side of it normally is. Basically, the topic today is Crackjack or the MIB. Which one's the greater threat to BZ Power?
Mm-hmm.
LJ says the Crackjack is a greater threat, and I say the MIB is a greater threat. Now, how this is going to work is that, I don't know, does anyone here have a timer? We're going to start with probably like 1.5 minutes. Yeah, 1.5 minutes. I'm not sure how that winds up. Minute. Whatever. LJ starts by giving out what he thinks he should give out, you know, his opening statements, and I'll respond to my opening statements. After that, we enter into a rebuttal stage, and we just, you know, just start arguing each other, basically.
Then we're going to hit cross-examination, and then the various sequels until Apollo...
Elena, this is your time to shine. Pull out your timer. I know you have one.
How did you know I... All right. How long do you want it to go?
1 minute, 30 seconds, if you please, Elena.
All right. 90 seconds, all right. Here we go. On your mark,
okay.
Get set, go.
LJ, hit it.
All right. Honestly, I think Crackjack is... which one did I say was the bigger threat?
Crackjack.
Okay, good. I think Crackjack is the bigger threat to BZ Power... as a form, because it can be argued that BZ Power is practically just a newspaper without its members, but I think even with the members there, it's still a place, you know, a form website, and he had the ability to literally take that down. He took down the news, 12 years of news within a 5-minute time span. Imagine what else he could have taken down. If he really wanted, and if BZ Power did not have backups, he could have absolutely annihilated BZ Power as a website, which, quite honestly, I think is a bigger threat than the MIB going up against the members, which, while they do populate BZ Power would still operate with little to none members. And actually, that's about it.
All right. How many seconds remaining, Luna?
We are at one. We are at 62 seconds.
Okay. Well, anyhow, Ode's over. Start again at 90. I'm probably going to need this if I go on this long. All right. Everyone start.
All right. On your mark, get set, go.
All right. From where I stand, I see the MIB is the greatest threat to music power as a whole. All right. Even though, regardless of what they did to the members, like what they did last time, the Lady Kopaka was just, you know, just horrendous. But they seem more malicious than Crackjack. Crackjack seems to be like, he seems just to want to liberate Mizzy Power, and regardless if that's a good reason or not, he doesn't seem to want to actively harm the members. The MIB have had a history before of threatening to harm the members through credit card information, selling information, releasing it on the internet, as they threatened to be Power staff before. They hacked Lady Kopaka's DeviantArt, her match host, and her account. All of which are, you know, somewhat heinous. But not only that, they have also brought trouble to the board as well. They, you know, like, Crackjack brought down the news, but they were recently, you know, the staff had a backup, which was, you know, which is good and fortunate. MIB brought down the forums as a whole for several months. They caused the dataclysm. They caused, you know, basically this backlog of forum posts, new topics, new blog posts, whatever. All of that was gone. They literally brought down Mizzy Power, and they erased a lot of the data that it had, because, you know, some of the backups were corrupted, if I remember right. Basically, MIB has caused more trouble to Mizzy Power than Crackjack has, and they seem to be more malicious and intense than Crackjack is. You know, even as far as he did the, you know, just take down the news and articles, I doubt he would go so far as to hacking several members and trying to get information out of them just to try to have some leverage over the staff. Right, and that's it for me. Time?
1:47.
Barely. I went over time. You're supposed to stop me when I go over, Alina. But it's okay. It's okay. It's cool.
So is that the purpose of a timer? Is like you just keep it running?
Yeah. All right. So, okay. All right, so, that would go as well, I hope. But anyhow, I guess now we just enter a rebuttal stage, in which we don't have statements at all. We just say stuff to one another and just argue.
Yeah, I'll start screaming at the top of your lungs. No, I'm kidding.
Okay, all right. Elder, what do you have to say to rebuttal me?
You're fat, you smell, you eat everyone's pets, you are a horrible person inside. Oh, wait. Oh. Okay, sorry, anyway. All right, so honestly, I think that Crackjack is a bigger threat, not because of what he did, but of what he's capable of. We've seen what the MIB is capable of, but we also know what Crackjack is also possibly capable of. He was able to take down 12, you know, all of BZ Power's news and threatened to go further. And the fact that he apparently was able to get into the database and bring the forms online. Who's to say he could not just absolutely destroy the forms? Because apparently, he also banned 3 staff members from BZ Power when he was in there. I still honestly think he could get in somewhere where he could cause more trouble than the MIB did.
Well, for me, right, from my point of view, when I think of Crackjack, I think of this guy that just wants to do something towards the staff. He just wants to maybe, like, you know, stick the middle finger up to him or something. You know, he just wants to antagonize them. And he's not doing it in a way that, like, you know, that legitimately would make the staff want to worry. The MIB always took this route in which, if you don't do this, we will make somebody else's life miserable. We will make, you know, LK's life miserable. We will make these members, if you have social security information or, you know, whatever information out of them, we'll make their lives miserable if you don't do this. They're more like a terrorist group. Crackjack seems to be more of an activist. And because of that, I don't think he's that much of a greater threat. Because as far as he can go, he wouldn't go to the extent that the MIB would. And not only that, he was shut down rather quickly yesterday. And today, as you can see, the forums are still here. So obviously, something must have happened. I think that the MIB still pose a larger threat to Mizzy Power as a whole, as opposed to Crackjack. Just because of that, you know, like I said again, because of malicious intent and because of the way they approach this sort of thing.
While that is a good point, I honestly think Crackjack
as a whole, he wanted to liberate BZ Power, but in doing that, he also kind of destroyed it. I think near the end, it kind of got to the point where he didn't care what happened to the form. So he just, you know, kind of started doing things. And I, you know, he probably would not do anything to the members. But the members is not what we're talking about. It's the form itself. While the MIB did hit the members and make their lives miserable, only certain members, you know, Crackjack went after the site, which would in turn destroy the form. And, you know, render membering useless.
Yeah. Well, I guess the MID were the cause of that eclipse. If that does not count as attacking the website, I don't know what does. And that eclipse was, quite honestly, the biggest and most successful attack on BZ Power ever made.
It ruined my BZ life.
Wow, Meso.
Wow.
Dude. Oh, wait. He's right. Meso's right. Meso, it deleted, like, everything you had on BZ Power.
Can I say something?
I joined... sure.
Thank you to whoever ruined Misa's BZ Power life. Thank you.
You're thanking hackers.
But no, it's like I joined in November and we lost all data back till September 08. So I was basically starting from scratch. I can speak from the perspective of a common kid using BZP. They ruined my life. All Crackjack did was provide lols, but he also scares me for the future.
Wow.
Okay, go ahead.
I still honestly think that Crackjack has potential to be more deadly toward BZ Power as a whole. Maybe not the members, per se. Because I honestly think, I don't know if he's an outside source, or if he's actually a member. But I still think that he is more of a threat in that A, he's current, B, he attacked recently while the MIB seemed to have died off effectively, and C, he's on the inside. The MIB were always outside attacks. Sure, they got into things, but still, Crackjack, I think more than not, is an insider.
Technically speaking, Crackjack's also outside. Unless you mean he's actually a staff member.
No.
Took
no.
down the farm on the inside. That's what inside job counts as.
That would be interesting.
It would be a lot of political intrigue, let me tell you that. But, yeah.
Don't tell
me. Continue.
But I still think, you know, members aside, he is a bigger threat to the form as a whole. Considering the amount of control he had after one attack.
Well, technically speaking, I'm assuming the MIB had the same amount of control, too. To lock the staff out of the forms, you do need to first, you know, like, he demoted all of them. He demoted all the staff, according to Crackjack, and then he removed all the groups. Like, yeah, he removed the man members group. I think he promoted everybody to Premier, or he was going to. I'm not sure which. But,
it doesn't matter to me. I won my 6-month Premier, which is currently going down the tubes, fair and square.
It's funny because it's true.
I know,
Fox
right?
6! I earned my right to free Premier membership! And by that, I meant made some comics. Give me my ability to be Premier!
It's kind of an interesting thought of all the ramifications that could happen from deleting the band members group. It literally would be like a breakout. Everyone would be unbanned to rain havoc on everything.
Think about it, right? Unless they're going to go back and like ban every single member that has ever been made on BZ Power that was like a dupe account, a spam account, or whatever, that's going to take quite a while. I'm hoping to have some backup for that, but...
Yeah,
if not,
they probably do. If not, it could be catastrophic. But, yeah.
Yeah. But, yeah, I still think he is the bigger threat because of his capabilities. Yes, the MIB did cause the dataclysm, but who's to say that Crackjack could not do that as well? Because from the extent of power he had, he showed, it seemed quite honestly like, you know, he could do that.
While Crackjag has, you know, effectively done all the things to be in power, I guess it still seems that the staff have a lot better security, I guess, than they used to have. They have more backups now. They have, you know, they have more security. Again, I think they're able to kick him out quicker than they were able to kick out the MIB before. I think, like, I didn't really feel threatened by Crackjag, whatever Crackjag was trying to do.
Well, I
as
know.
Much as the MID, you know, began to terrorize people.
That's because they were not. Yeah. Crackjag was not going after the members; he was going after the form. But then again, that still stands to reason. If he was going to go after the form, that would mean he's a bigger threat to the form. While the MIB were kind of a threat to everything generally, I didn't get the sense that they had as much control over the form as much as they did the members.
But here's the thing: once you start to scare away the members, what is the form? I mean, you could get, if Crackjag succeeds in taking down form, give it, you would say, half a year, okay, because that's how long it took last time. BZ Power starts again. Members come back again. Maybe a few, more fewer, because, you know, the whole, that, you know, like, they're getting tired of this dataclysm thing, but members will still come back. If the MIB starts, you know, threatening members and scares them away from the site, there's more to scare away from the site, the more members leave. And when they leave, they're probably not going to come back. That would destroy the forms a lot more than just bringing them down.
True. But
I'm going to break the rules of this segment and chime in real quick and say that's kind of interesting, the dichotomy between the MIB and Crackjag. Because Crackjag actually got into the forum software. The MIB just hacked into people's accounts. But then from there, they could do damage, too. Like, all they ever did was just guess passwords and use password crackers. And they just so happened to get into an admin's account and then cause the dataclysm. And with the Crackjag, he didn't do any of that. And instead, he got into the forums. And from there, he could do the exact same stuff the MIB could, different methods.
He got into an admin account, technically. Basically, you can use several accounts to get into the software. Now, I'm not going to say I'm no hacking major by far. So if you actually know what you're talking about and you hear me saying something that's completely stupid, I'm sorry. It's just what I heard. Okay, so I'm not claiming to be an expert on this whatsoever. I think from what I heard, you use an account to get in into the software itself by using Worm or using some code. We're always saying, like, you need to know the right tools. Apparently, like, he was able to take control of an admin account and, like, or get an account and promote that to admin and then ban everybody else. That's how it worked. You know, now, like, I'm not 100% sure, but it's somewhere along those same lines. I guess, like, the MIB could have done that. But instead, they chose to, you know, they catalyzed the staff in a different approach. Rather than taking the forms down, I guess they did take the forms down. But, you know, rather than doing that, they switched over to trying to threaten members. Sending weird PMs and all that stuff.
Oh, y'all.
Yeah. Oh, I remember the PMs. Yeah, the first time I got one of those PMs, my chair quite literally fell backwards. And, it was not fun. Anyway. But, yeah, true. But Crackjag, he also was able to ban 3 staff members. And while the MIB were able to get into staff member accounts, from what it seems, so was he. He could have caused a dataclysm right then and there, but he didn't. Because even though he didn't have the malicious intent, he still had the ability to do so. And I think anyone who has the ability to do so, I would not count out the possibility of them doing so at any point in time. And which is why I think Crackjag is still a bigger threat, because he did it quicker and easier than the MIB.
I would say that he did it quicker and easier, not necessarily because of skill, but because of the way he wanted to target things. To me, the MIB is, like, I feel more threatened by MIB, again, because they do threaten the members, but also because they seem more like terrorists, I guess. they seem to want something, and if you don't give it to them, you know, you're gonna really get it. Crackjack also tried to implement that too, but when he deleted the entire news thing, it was more of like, oh well, I guess they'll be back at some point, as opposed to like, oh well, I guess I could get screwed over for this. The MIB, like, when you say he didn't just ban three staff members, he banned them all. So I mean, like, it's not just like if you ban them, they're banned for life. Once Killy found a way to get in there and ban everybody else, he promoted all the staff members back. So it's not like, you know, it's not like something worse than what he's done. But at the moment, even though Crackjack is still a threat, I'd still say that the MIB, like, if you could choose two people to attack Music Power, I would rather have Crackjack attack it than the MIB, because I feel that Crackjack's attacks would be resolved sooner, like they have been now, right? Mm-hmm. Like the news was up in a matter of hours. Apparently the forums are just being patched. That's where you're offline, but the forums are still, you know, active. Even though he's trying to do stuff now, the staff still are. They're doing better at this and responding more quickly than I remember from responding to the MIB attacks.
I'm glad the news is back, or else what would we do?
We wouldn't have the fantastic news segment. Yeah. All those Bionicle news.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Nah, but all right. Well, I still think that Crackjack would be a bigger threat because he has a greater know-how, and he quite nearly toppled BZ Power in one attack after the MIB took several. But I have nothing more to say, and that ends my argument.
All right. I guess as your closing statement, I'll make mine too. To me, the MIB have had a longer history in BZ Power of attacking it and doing something malicious to it, something that would, you know, actively hurt it. To me, the MIB still stands the more formidable opponent because of the stuff that they could do, not only to the site, but to the members in addition. Crackjack's attempts seem to be focused supremely on the site. And as such, I feel like, you know, if you have the site or the site with members, the site with members takes precedence in my mind as the more threatening approach to it. Crackjack, also, like, some of the stuff he did, you know, the all your base belong to us, and the having his contact information, having his Twitter up, responding to all those tweets. I don't know. It doesn't seem as malicious as the MIB. Right? Like, the MIB tried to be, like, I guess, anonymous. And Crackjack he's just sort of, you know, trying to do stuff just because he thinks he's doing some noble cause here. That's my closing statement.
Well, it was a well-fought battle, guys.
All right, now, let's ask the outside source, Alina, what do you think about our arguments?
Because I have not been paying attention, I will just say this. They were all very educational, interesting, and something that people should truly and sincerely care about.
Okay.
That is...
Well, leave a comment in the comments below, I guess, say who you thought was the better argument, or say none if you were like Luna and just skipped over his part and didn't pay attention to us, even though you're supposed to be part of the cast. Yeah.
And then if you're a BZP member who was there for, you know, both of them, or have heard about both of them, post what you think the bigger threat is, MIB or Crackjack. Who will win?
The next debate corner will review any comments, if there are any, see what other people think. Because, you know, mm-hmm. We just debate. We don't actually do anything. That's the whole purpose of debating. We don't actually do anything. So we want to hear your opinions, too, from a not working standpoint.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. And what was that, Alina?
And comment if you think that Hop should be net part of the next TTV episode.
Okay. I'm putting my vote, so.
But y'all.
Too hungry now. Cat on here. All right.
Good job, guys.
Thank you.
And now, it's been a fun ride. We must now end it because all things have an ending. Like Bionicle. Foreshadowing. Anyway.
Talk about sneak on the corner.
Yeah, but thank you for listening. Appreciate your viewership as always. If you have anything to say to Bait Corner, post it in the comments. And remember to like, comment, rate, favorite, subscribe.
Dang it. I will hop this in. You have one debate corner just on that. You have to say it on YouTube videos. Anyhow.
Well, they can post in the comments and be like, I rate this 5 out of 5. But anyway, thank you for listening. I'm Mesonak.
I'm LJ.
I'm Tahir.
This was TTV episode.